Sharon, I have been having a rough time trying to make this video for y'all, but I am determined I'm going to do this before I go to bed this morning. It's right now, it's 5:05 a.m. And technology and old folks, sometimes they just don't mix. They like gasoline and fire. And it's not working for me. But I'm going to try it again anyhow. I made a whole 35, 40 minute video and the sound didn't come through. It was beautiful. I looked so good. My lipstick was all nice and good. Hey, we're going to try this again. Anyhow, I couldn't do the video I had yesterday. I did it on my phone and my phone, I can't access it. Hey, I'm sorry. No more excuses. I'm just going to go ahead. I'm going to do two reviews today. I'm going to do January the 2nd review and January the 3rd review, and I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to get up in the first thing in the morning, take a shower, and do January 4th review. So, there we go. Okay, first review is, I want to show you what I'm using as part of my review. This is called a fragrance journal. Fragrance journal. I got this from Amazon. And it was $9.99. I'll put the link in the description. And it's an affiliate link, so if you buy it, I might get, I think, 20 cents, something like that. I get 2%. 2% is 2%? Mm-hmm. 20%. $20. 20 cents, not $20. 20 cents. So, I hope you buy one. I got this particular one because it has 200 pages, and I can have one for each of my fragrances. In the book, it has fragrance review. And I don't know if you can see this very good, but it talks about the longevity, your initial thoughts. You can put the names of the fragrance and the fragrance houses, top, middle, heart notes, base notes, review the strengths and weaknesses. You can do make a summary about the longevity, any recommendations. In thoughts, initial thoughts and feelings, the date that the perfume came out, whether you wear it in the spring, summer, fall, that's for you, your decision, and or night or day, whatever. Now, I have to say that in the Middle East, it's hot there all the time, so they wear their fragrances. It's always summer, so that's when they wear their fragrances. They don't not just wear something because it's hot, because it's always hot, but I don't either. I wear it when I want to wear it. If it smells good, I feel like wearing, I wear it. Also, the unisex and male and female fragrances, it's really a westernized thing. In the Middle East, they wear, it's everything's unisex. And so they just make it female and male just for westernized noses. So, enough of that. We're going to go right into it because I don't want to make this real long and I want to go to bed. Okay, for the one that I tried to make for you before was Rosa Rosa. This is Rosa Rosa. I really love the smell of it. The bottle is beautiful. This was $28. Let's see, how much was this? This was, Rosa Rosa was $28.99, which is right at the top of my spend limit. 35 is my spending limit. And then, but it was also available on, I think, on the Swiss Arabian, because that's where I first saw it, on Swiss Arabian website. $59.99 with $11.88 shipping. I was not going to spend that $70, $72. I wasn't spending, no way in the world I was spending $72 for that bottle, girl. Nope. Mm-mm. That does not match my Social Security and my pension. Nope. Okay. But Swiss Arabian, you can get some really great sales. So I would suggest go to SwissArabian.com, sign up for their newsletter, and their thing that they can send you, you know, your push on your text messages, and you can get some really great bargains that way. The sprayer was a little flimsy, and actually it came off, I hadn't even used it hardly. It just kind of sits there. I know it's not supposed to be that way. I had to watch how I spray from the bottle, because if I sprayed it from this direction like this, it made the spray go down on here. Oops, I'm sorry. If I sprayed from this direction, it made the spray would end up on here. And that's a waste of spray. So I had to turn around this way so my hand could grip it closer and then I could spray it that way. So I'm going to show you what it looks like when I spray it. All right. Rosa, Rosa. Also, this is the scent stick that I use. Rosa, Rosa, EDP. And then on the back, I write the fragrance house, which is Cali. I got this from the Swiss Arabian. Is I think it's the importer for this, because they do not sell this off their website in the United States. So here we go. So I want you to be able to see this. If you can see this or not. Yeah, nice spray. Nice spray. And I like it. I really like it. Okay, put that back on there. And again, this is Rosa Rosa. Beautiful bottle. Beautiful bottle. Beautiful. Okay. Rosa Rosa. My, it was 3.4 ounces. It's almost half a cup. It's a perfume, eau de parfum. My initial thoughts were that it was light, sweet, floral, musky, fresh, and fruity. It also said in the description I was reading, it said it's spicy and a light mint. I didn't detect any mint or spiciness at all. Top notes, sweet floral, white floral, fresh greens. I don't know the difference between white floral and sweet floral. No, we're going to learn this together. Okay, I'm just saying. Middle notes, white jasmine, floral, and velvety. It's kind of a smooth feel to it, a smell to it. Vanillic, sweet, burnt, sugary, musky. I got the musky, but I did not detect the vanillic. But it may be there. I just didn't detect it. Okay? And burnt sugary, didn't taste, smell like burnt sugar to me. Huh? I don't like burnt sugar. It says bittersweet floral with orange, tonka bean, and tonka bean blossom, grass rose. I don't know what grass rose smell like. Don't know that. Nope. Sprayer was flimsy. Sprayed all over the bottleneck as I sprayed it. It does have a very fine mist. Olfactory fatigue is what I think I had when I had this, because after like 4 hours, I couldn't smell it anymore. Couldn't smell it anymore. So I asked my husband if he could smell it. He could. He was able to smell it on my arm for about 4 hours. But it didn't. I wouldn't buy this again, mainly because it didn't last as long as I liked, and also because it was 28. Was it? What did I say? It was $28.99. That's over my budget. You know, I'm trying to wean my budget because you know. We got a little raise with our Social Security, but I don't want to spend it all on that. So I'm trying to rein my budget back to $30 rather than the $35 that I had initially. But if I see something I really, 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 really like, I might spring for the $35. Yes. Okay. The next, let me see. Next is the, what is that? Oh, the Fake Delilah. And again, I would not buy this one again. If it were $20, I'd buy it in a heartbeat. Yeah, I would. Because I could respray it. But for this much, and I got to respray it every 2 hours or so, and it just didn't. I like to be able to smell it all through the day on myself, and I couldn't smell it after a while. Okay, the next one, I call this one Fake Delilah. Delilah. And this is supposed to be a dupe for Parfums de Marly, Delina. I don't know, because I've never smelled Delina. And I can't afford $300 for a bottle of perfume. Yes. If I don't want to spend $35 on one, I'm sure not going to spend $300 on one. Nope, not doing that. but I'm going to go on a field trip. I have a girlfriend in Maryland, and we're going to go sniffing at some of the upper crust stores, you know, like Elizabeth Arden and Nordstrom's, Macy's, and all like that. Yeah, we're going to go sniffing around because I have a clue what these original ones smell like. She has a lot of the original ones, but I don't have that. Nope, don't have that. So we're going to go and smell them. This one is by a company called Metabozum. Now, it's supposed to be a Middle Eastern company, but nobody seems to know anything about that company. Nobody's ever heard of them. They have a lot of different perfumes, but and I don't know how they perform, but I do have been reading some of the reviews, and one of the reviews says, stay away from this company. I don't know why, other than the fact that it doesn't perform very well. I don't know about all the other perfumes that they have, but this one, it's a very poor dupe of Parfums de Marly. It was a very poor dupe of Delilah. Now, Mason Alhambra makes one called Delilah as well, and that one smells heavenly. Oh, it's wonderful. This not so much. Right out the bottle, it did smell like it, but that didn't last more than 15, 20 minutes. Really, and I'm not, you know. Now, I did go to my husband again, his trusty nose, and ask him if he could smell it. And he could smell it after 2 hours. I could not smell it after 15, 20 minutes. I didn't smell anything. Nope. And the paper that I sprayed it on, just completely, it just disappeared. I didn't see it anymore. Let me see here. I'm going to show you how this one sprays. This is, I call this the fake Parfums de Marly. Okay. Let's see where it go. And I have, like I did, I put on here, that's the name of the company, Metabozum, B-O-S-E-M, and I got it on Amazon, and I called it, I called this fake Delilah. Okay, let me do this. All right, here we go. You can see this. It has a nice spray. It does have a nice spread. I can barely smell it. I mean, right out the bottle, I can barely smell it. This drove me nuts today because I couldn't wear anything else on top of it. So I went around. I didn't go anywhere today either. But I couldn't smell myself. And I want to smell myself. Okay? I want to smell myself. Okay. Would not buy that one again. When I bought it, I paid, let me see how much I paid for this. When I bought this, I paid $10.59. After smelling this, it was too much. The current price on Amazon is $21.95. Do not buy this. I'm going to put the link for it in my description. If you want to buy this, I would suggest if you want to have a little girl that you want to buy something like this, she wants to play Barbie, buy her this. If you want to buy something cute for her teacher, buy her this. You know, this is not going to last. This is not going to be off-putting to anybody because it's not going to last long enough to be off-putting. It's very soft, very weak. Like my grandmother said, it's water dash. You know, like your tea with ice cubes that melted and it's water dashed, and that's what this is like. It's water, like somebody put water in here. It's just no. The sprayer was okay, but the bottle and the presentation was kind of cheap. It's just not very. Yeah. The paint's coming off of it. You can see the paint coming off of it right here. Oops, paint coming off of it right here. Yeah, no, cheap. Wouldn't buy it again. The fragrance out of the bottle smelled very familiar, like Mason Alhambra Delilah. But like I said, by the time it dried down, it was gone. And I'm a heavy sprayer. I spray till it run down my arms and drip down on the floor. I love to spray my perfumes all over the place. And after a half hour, I couldn't smell it anymore. But again, it was a skin scent, and my husband did say he could smell it after 2 hours, but I couldn't smell it. I like to spray the back of my hands when I spray my perfumes so that I can kind of sit and, you know, and refresh myself because I love the way they smell. and I can do this and still be kind of coy, you know. You know, versus if they're going, you know, you're well, she's, you know, hey, and you can't spell behind you. Yeah, so I like to do this. Or, you know, something like this, and I can still smell it. That's what I like. I couldn't do that with this. Couldn't do it with this one at all. And I couldn't do it with this one. This one lasts a little longer, but I couldn't do it with that very long. I like to be able to do that all day long without having to spray all over the place. I prefer fragrance that I can smell what I call at will. I want to be able to enjoy my fragrance through all the layers as long as they last. All the dry downs, I want to enjoy that. And this was definitely not what I got with the Lena. I'm going to pass this along to my granddaughters. And the notes for this says it opens with a sensual. I'm reading this description on the website. It says this fragrance opens with the sensual and compelling citruses combined with the lovely peony. I did smell a little peony in it. Yeah, I think it did. And then, but I didn't smell any citrus. The heart note full bloom is a romantic rose and mysterious osmanthus. I don't know what osmanthus smells like. And I didn't smell much rose. The final impact of sandalwood, pink pepper, and patchouli. I don't know what patchouli smells like, and I don't know what pink pepper smells like, but I do know what sandalwood smells like because I have sandalwood liqueur that I have that I burn in my liqueur burner, but I didn't smell that in it. But I did get a whiff of the peony, and it was powdery, sweet. It was not offensive, but it just didn't last long. So this would be nice for a little girl to have, take to school, put in her locker or something like that. Yeah, I think so. The value of this, $10, if you want to try it, go ahead. But I'm telling you, save your money for something else. Don't buy that. Don't buy that. If you want to buy this, if you want to, it was okay, but didn't last. You'd have to respray this all day long. Okay. Now, I wanted to show you some of the rest of the ones that I'm going to be doing. The one for tomorrow. This is the one for tomorrow called Berries Weekend. Can you see that? Berries Weekend. And I have worn it. You can see I've been wearing it. Berries Weekend. I don't wear it that often, but Berries Weekend. I like this. Berries Weekend. And then the next day, which is Saturday, I don't know what the day is. The day is Thursday. Okay, this is Friday. This is Friday. I think this is what I'm wearing Friday. If it's not, we'll figure it out. This is Reina. This is Reina. And this is by Mason Alhambra, Reina. This is supposed to be a dupe of Parfums de Marly, Delina Exclusive. I don't know what that smells like, but I love this. This is awesome. And then this is the next day. This is Velvet Rose. And you can see this is one of my favorites because this is half gone. Velvet Rose. Beautiful. Isn't that pretty? Velvet Rose. I love it. And then I think this is Sunday. I don't know. Whatever the seventh day is going to be Nerissa. This is Nerissa. And this is going to be a dupe for Narciso. Somebody? Narciso? Don't know what that smells like either. But this one, I like this one too. I do. I like that. Yeah. So, that's what I'm going to be having. I'm on day three, going to day four later today because the day is Thursday. And this is day four. This is January. Let me look on my computer. Yep, this is January the 4th. So that's the one I'm going to do today. So I'll take a shower this morning with the fragrant list, with no fragrance, moisturizer, and no layering. It's going to be just pure Berries Weekend for you all. And this is by Fragrance World. It is a Middle Eastern company. I think it's in Tanzania, though. Yeah. Anyhow, I have more stuff I want to let you know tomorrow. In the meantime, this is it, and I'm getting ready to go to bed. Bless my little husband, he in there waiting for me. And like I said, I'm going to try to upload this for you all, and have all the notes and stuff on it, and hopefully it goes up. If it doesn't, I just have to wait till the next day, because I got locked out of my YouTube account. We'll see. All right. Bye-bye, guys. I love you all so much. Thank you for joining me. Be sure to subscribe and follow me. Okay? Bye-bye. This old lady smells good all the time. Bye-bye.